Hi folks, Will from MinIO here. We are continuing our series on replication. In this video, we're going to take a look at how to do site replication in our lab environment. So let's go ahead and jump right in. So site replication takes a little more work. First off, when you set up site replication, you need to make sure that you are using sites that do not have any data on them. So this is something that you are going to do when you initially set up your MinIO deployment. If you have data, if you have objects on your MinIO deployment, you can only have them on one of your clusters in your replication set. So let me show you what I mean. If I do an MCLS on MinIO 3, there's nothing there yet. If I do an MCLS on MinIO 1, you know, we've got bucket REPL there. But MinIO 3 has nothing on it right now. So I can add MinIO 3 to my site replication. So if I do an MC admin replicate, okay, so that's the difference right there. I am not using MC replicate anymore. I'm using MC admin replicate now. So MC admin replicate, I'm going to add MinIO 1, MinIO 3. Now, MinIO 1 has data on it, MinIO 3 doesn't. So I need to put MinIO 1 first. I'm not going to try to add MinIO 2 to this because MinIO 2 has data on it, and I don't want to deal with having to delete that right now. So I'm just going to add MinIO 1, MinIO 3. There we go. Request sites were configured for replication successfully. And so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to create a new bucket, MB, on MinIO 3, and I'm going to call it bucket site. So, do I have to create bucket site on MinIO 1? No, I don't. Do I have to set up versioning on this bucket? Well, it turns out that I do not have to set up versioning on this. Because I am doing site replication, and because replication requires versioning, if I do an MC version info on MinIO 3 bucket site, guess what? Versioning is automatically enabled when I stand it up. I do not have to enable versioning separately. Remember, versioning is required when you are replicating data. So since I am using site replication, turning on versioning now becomes the default setting. I can't even turn it off. Okay, let's do it that MCLS MinIO 1 now. When I do MCLS MinIO 1, I see my bucket REPL is there and my bucket site has now been added. So I have both of those available. And this happened even though I stood up that bucket site on MinIO 3. This is active from the beginning. If I upload a file, MCCP, sample text, up to MinIO 1, bucket site, site1.txt, and I do my MCLS MinIO 1 bucket site this time. Okay. There it is. It's there. And if I do the same command on MinIO 3, it is there as well. Okay. So I'm already set up active between MinIO 1 and MinIO 3. Now, what if I want to add another site to the list? I had mentioned you want to put the one that with data on first, and then everything else needs to be blank. Well, it turns out once you have this replication going, you can add to it very easily. MC admin replicate add. Now, here's the key. I need to list all of the existing sites first, and then I can add MinIO 4 to my list of replication sites. Any healthy peer site can be the first server. You have to list all the replication sites in your list. Okay, so MinIO 1, MinIO 3, didn't matter which one I listed first. They're both healthy. Everything's fine there. If I do an MC admin replicate info MinIO 1, notice that it tells me that I've got MinIO 1, MinIO 3, and MinIO 4 all available there. So if I now do an MCLS MinIO 4 bucket site, MCLS MinIO 4 bucket site now also has the site 1 as well. The speed of replication, by the way, is dependent on a number of different things. I'm running all of this in the cloud on a very limited server, so it just takes it a second. There is our site replication. By the way, I can still do all the fun things like MC stat. I can get MC admin replicate status and see everything that's going on there. So this is a really powerful tool to stand up disaster recovery. You can add this at the bucket level at any time, but if you're doing this at the site level, you need to make sure that you're adding sites that have no data on them to begin with. And what you end up with is a very robust network of replication beyond what you get from erasure coding and all that other fun stuff. Allowing all of this stuff to replicate makes a lot of sense if you are definitely running something where disaster recovery is important. So, just some ideas there for you to take away. Hopefully you enjoyed this little video. If you would like to reach out with us, you can use any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can also reach out to us on slack.min.io or just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.